The purpose of this demonstration is to illustrate the steps required when creating the Thevenin equivalent circuit. Thevenin's theorem states that any two-terminal circuit made up of fixed value resistances and of voltage and current sources can be replaced by a single voltage source in series with a single resistance, which will produce the same effects at the terminals. The application of Thevenin's theorem can be very useful when considering the behavior of a fixed linear network with respect to changing load resistance values. By creating a simplified version of the network, we can greatly reduce the number of calculations required to analyze a circuit under varying load conditions. Once the Thevenin equivalent circuit has been determined, the voltage divider rule can be applied to acquire the load voltage for any given load resistance. The calculated value for load voltage can then be used to determine the load current simply by employing Ohm's law. In this way, voltage and current values for various load conditions can be quickly and easily obtained once the equivalent circuit has been created. There are four basic steps involved in creating a Thevenin equivalent circuit. In the first step of the process, we identify the portion of the network for which the Thevenin equivalent circuit is to be determined. We then label the two terminals as points A and B and remove the portion of the network that is not being included in the simplification. In the second step of the process, we determine the Thevenin equivalent resistance, RTH, by short-circuiting voltage sources and open-circuiting current sources in the network. We then calculate the resistance that appears between the two open terminals previously labeled points A and B. In step 3, we return all sources to their original state and position and determine the Thevenin equivalent voltage, ETH, which appears across the two terminals, A and B. To complete the process, we draw the Thevenin equivalent circuit. We use the values of ETH and RTH obtained from steps 1 through 3. We then place the removed portion of the circuit across the terminals A and B. For the purposes of this example, we've selected a simple network containing a single voltage source in order to demonstrate the procedure. We've assigned sample values to the voltage source and resistors in our network, and we will begin our conversion with step 1 of the process. First, we identify the portion of the network for which the Thevenin equivalent circuit is to be determined. Next, label the terminals connecting this portion to the remaining part of the circuit as points A and B. To complete the first step, remove the portion of the network that is not being included in the simplification. The next step in the process is to calculate the Thevenin equivalent resistance, RTH. We begin step 2 by removing and short-circuiting the single voltage source that is present in this network. We are now ready to calculate the Thevenin equivalent resistance, RTH, as seen between points A and B in the circuit. To do this, we reduce the remaining resistive network down to a single equivalent resistance. First, calculate the equivalent resistance of R1 in parallel with R2 by using the product over sum rule. Next, sum the series resistances R3 and REQ12. to complete the calculation of RTH, combine the parallel resistances R4 and REQ123. In this example, the Thevenin equivalent resistance is equal to 75 ohms. Once the Thevenin equivalent resistance has been determined, we move on to step 3 and find the Thevenin equivalent voltage, ETH. First, we return all sources in the portion of the network for which the Thevenin equivalent circuit is being determined to their original position and state. We then determine the value of ETH by calculating the voltage that appears across the two terminals labeled A and B. In this example, it can be seen that the voltage appearing across the two terminals will be equal to the voltage across R4. Also note that R3 and R4 create a voltage divider which splits the voltage being dropped by R2. Therefore, if the voltage across R2 can be determined, we can apply the voltage divider rule to acquire the Thevenin equivalent voltage as it appears between points A and B. To do this, calculate the equivalent resistance of R2 in parallel with the series combination of resistors R3 and R4. Start by summing the series resistors R3 and R4 to provide the equivalent resistance REQ34. Next, find the equivalent resistance of R2 in parallel with REQ34 by applying the product over sum rule. The voltage divider rule can now be applied to calculate the voltage appearing at what is now labeled as point C in the circuit. The voltage appearing at point C in this example is equal to 8 volts. Applying the voltage divider rule using the acquired voltage at point C will provide us with the Thevenin equivalent voltage, ETH. The Thevenin equivalent voltage, ETH, is equal to 6 volts in this example. Now that the values of ETH and RTH have been determined, we move on to the final step in the process, step 4. In step 4, we redraw the circuit and use the calculated values for ETH and RTH to create the Thevenin equivalent circuit for our original network. Finally, we return the portion of the circuit that was removed in step 1 at points A and B. The behavior of the original network and the Thevenin equivalent circuit are identical with respect to points A and B. The Thevenin equivalent circuit provides a simplified representation of the original network. This in turn will greatly reduce the number of calculations required to determine how the original network responds to various load conditions.